Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel, The Real Deal Gaming. We're here today with Hades, a title that's a few years old now, but still an incredible game to play. Essentially an isometric, rogue type, you know all the titles that everyone says. but today I wanted to teach you some of the basics of how to enjoy this wonderful title that I've played to death, but can be a little intimidating to get into, mainly due to its difficulty and kind of confusion revolving attacks, builds, all the complicated stuff to do with games. So I'm here today on a brand new save file, first attempt going through. Obviously I've played the game many times, but I had an empty save file, wanted to show it to you from the very beginning in hopes that I can kind of teach you as we go along. You can see how we progress. Now, as you know, here on my channel, I don't always play perfectly, and that's not really the point. So you'll notice I'll probably make some mistakes, I'm going to die along the way. That's just the way this game works. You're actually meant to die. Lesson one, you're going to die. Even the pros that you see play, they've died many times along the way. This might as well be the, dare I say, Dark Souls of isometric games. You're going to die at some points. Don't worry about that, though. You're going to get used to it. At first, it's going to seem like a pain in the rear end, but trust me, you'll get used to it. Alright, so this very first playthrough, you really don't have much in the way of weapons to choose from. There will be some that we'll play later on, but for the moment, we have just this sword. I won't go to too much of the basics, honestly. If you're trying to become familiar with games, if you're trying to work your way in, this is probably not the first game for you to give a try. Realistically, this is meant more for those that looking for kind of a challenge, have been gaming for, you know, several months, years, that sort of thing. So I'll skip over things like what button attacks and what buttons for, etc. I'll probably go over some of the details of what means what, but I'm going to assume you got a bit of a primer before you come in. So, the first run through, let's find some people to kill. Alright, so as you can see, the first god that we're going to encounter here, in case you don't know by the icon, this is Athena.
I'm leaving.
And actually, in case you're not aware, this first time through, some of these, I guess you could say, rooms or setups that you'll have are actually quite not randomized at all. For example, Athena will always be the first god that you encounter, no matter what. Since we have a sword, and honestly, we just don't have much in the way of, well, we don't have anything built up for our character yet, we're going to be focusing on survivability. You know, we're new to the game in this case, or at least we're kind of rolling along with that assumption. Yes, we need survivability, which is what makes Athena perfect. Almost all of her boons or gifts that she'll give are going to be defensive. Now, I'm going to kind of skip through the story. I want you to enjoy that on your own if you ever choose to play it yourself. It's a fantastic story. It's probably not, you know, as in-depth and pulling you in as like a RPG, but it's got plenty to offer, so. Let's see here. Under the circumstances, we'll start off simple. We'll just pick something to increase the strength of our attack. If we see something... Well, actually, under the circumstances, this divine dash would be better. Essentially, we're going to pick that, and while it doesn't increase the damage of our main attack, it does mean you can dash into or out of something and give you a temporary reflection and vulnerability. So you're invulnerable. In that microsecond, you can't be heard, and you'll even send attacks back. This is kind of one of those things where if you can master the timing on it, it'll give you far more of a benefit than just a little bit extra damage increase on that sword. The key icon's useful for unlocking weapons and things in the mirror, resetting certain aspects. Keys are definitely useful, although as you progress in the game, you'll notice that they kind of come less and less useful. Dash is your friend. Don't be afraid to use God mode as well, by the way. This is kind of a mode you can use to essentially lower the difficulty by making it so you take less damage during the run. It's not a shameful thing to give a try. I have my own save with one enabled just for the fun of it. It's honestly not a big deal. Try to find the best thing that works for you. Honestly, the only thing it does is just decrease the amount of damage you take. It doesn't affect anything else.
Come on in. That sound.
Oh, Dionysus.
People having a good.
We like him. He definitely provides several abilities, but we're not really looking for much in the way of his damaging effects on the sword today. We want to get something else, whether it be like a cast effect, such as Trippy Shot, or we're looking for something that'll bring us back in health over time. And that's mainly because we're just so weak so far. Let's pick something. Let's go with... I like After Party. Kind of give us the ability to always make sure at the end of the battle we have health, even if we really got beaten up. A little bit of patience, good timing. You can always get past these armored enemies. When given a chance between Cairn, which is sort of a merchant, or I believe that's his name, Cairn. I always forget names. You'll notice I'm horrible with names. But to choose between him and then, of course, something else. Usually you want to go to something else if you're so low on cash. Like, as you can see on the bottom right, I only have 54 gold. That's not going to buy much. So let's choose the heart icon instead, the centaur heart. We do want the extra health. In this case, it'll be a total of 25 extra health. Not only does that give us increased survivability, of course, but also a larger threshold with which that we'll regain our health in the event of, becoming really low after battle. Money or Dionysus again. Well, we do need an increase in our damage, but also some money would be really helpful. I think in this case, we don't have a lot of money to begin with. Let's continue building up some boons and go with Dionysus. Oh, a boss battle. Beating these bosses is really, this first sort of mini-boss is really just a matter of trying to find a way to dodge as many bombs as you can, honestly. If you can deflect them back at your target, even better. But we're just kind of burning our way through their bombs. When in doubt, don't be afraid to dash. Oh, we're getting pretty lucky here with their lack of movement as far as patterns are concerned, so I'll take that. And a nice successful run. Hangover is basically dot damage, or damage over time, if you're familiar with that, kind of like a poison or a slow effect. I don't really feel that's appropriate with the sword. We want to go for something a little bit different. So, let's see here. We don't want either of those. Let's go with premium vintage. Not only could we use the health, but at the same time, the actual nectar itself is really beneficial for your long-term game. You always want to pick up as much in the way of resources, like shadow, keys, nectars, and really anything you can, especially here early on.
Heads up.
Nice little deflect in there, as you can see. It's a great example of a boon that can be useful. As a matter of fact, I can kind of kill him without doing anything but damaging or deflecting in, through dodging. So, dash when you can. I'd like to get another key because I really would like to unlock more weapons, so that's the path that I'm going to focus on for the moment. Also, if it looks like it's some sort of contraption you can stand on, don't do it. More often than not, it's going to trigger a trap that will end up damaging you, or at least, as you can see, sort of distracting you, forcing you to play defensively. So, if possible, focus on where you're standing, stay off the pillars, stay off the pads.
on a key.
Excellent. Another centaur heart. It'll increase our chances of being able to build up a large enough health pool. We might even be able to survive a ways on this run. Really good, although I would recommend holding off on it. Once you master the timing, you can actually force them to smack themselves through that dashing deflect they referred to. Again, it works on any attack, you just need to properly time it. Though it's a bit of a high-risk, high-reward situation. Again, let's continue on with the key. Only option, as you can see, so hence why I kind of just jump straight to it. Sometimes you really just you get one option and that's it. Luckily on this map we'll have two. As you can see, it's taking a good fair amount of damage. Hopefully, it doesn't nip us in the butt later. Do need more boons, but let's see what Charon has available for us now.
Charon's shop. Well, good to see you, Charon, mate. Just my...
Let's go with the heart, but save the rest of our cash. We don't quite... Well... We don't quite have much in the way of the health. Let's go ahead and pick the food item for burger and fries. That way, hopefully, we can survive our very first real boss fight against one of the sisters. You'll see what I mean here in just a moment. Again, I don't want to ruin too much of the story for you. I want you to get a chance to enjoy it yourself. This is one of those things where you'll be working your way through many runs, many attempts. Each time, you'll gain a little bit more story along the way.
To go with
it. And then after. I want a taste of this.
Maybe, perhaps not. Let's do our best, maximum effort.
Scratch.
it. Oh, and she takes me down. Of course, as I said before, remember, that's the name of the game. You're gonna die a fair amount. As you get used to it, increase your resources and so forth.
Damn it.
Now I'm gonna do one more run here right now before I kind of split it up into the next video. I want to get a chance to sort of demonstrate to everyone what you can unlock, what you can do, all sorts of stuff.
Good to see you.
And fear is...
talking to every person you can find is help.
Stupid.
Greetings, Father.
Not only does it progress the story along, but at the same time, it can provide you with reward opportunities, so.
I believe it, Nick.
The risk is not.
Yes, we are.
Then go.
Surprise, Hypnos.
Whoa.
Cheers, Hypnos.
Now, the first time you give someone any form of nectar, you're going to get a reward for it. Some type of item that you can use while running through the game. Whether it be a boon or a benefit of some sort. And I chose to go with Hypnos specifically because of what he provides you with. In this case, what's called a Sathonic Purse. Sathonic Purse. It's basically meant to give you a certain amount of gold whenever you start up right off the bat without having to earn any more or what have you. Just a quick early boon. So. Let's see. Under the circumstances, I feel the best method for progression here early on when you're trying to learn is to get this Death Defiance. And so I'm actually going to save my shadow for that. Let's skip past that. Move on to the next area. This is where you choose your weapons or method of perk okay. Or what you're going to pick for moving forward. So, in this case, I'm going to pick up the bow.
There we go. Code unlocked. The Heartseeker. Let's deal some death.
Over here.
Got something new to try.
There we go. You see how I have that Sathonic Purse? Okay, pick it up. Nice. And the more enemies you kill with each one of these items increases its rank. Okay. So let's go ahead and make sure that's equipped.
That nice place. I don't remember.
And then move forward. Now we're choosing the bow. The bow's definitely much more beginner-friendly, in my opinion. It's easier to master. You can stay out of damage, stay out of the range of things. Hopefully we'll make it much further in this particular run than the last.
Is this really him?
There. Excellent. Under the this particular type of bow, this basic beginner bow, it's a bit more of your personal preference as far as what you want to pick. I don't particularly like shooting a fan special though, and then only getting one lightning bolt out of it, so because it's a basic bow, I'd recommend going with just the lightning strike, the regular attack boon. You're going to be using it more often.
Never thought I'd see the day, or night, whatever.
Of course, in case you weren't aware, if you find another boon that offers you a different form of attack, you can pick that instead. Sort of overriding your current ability. Now, while I'm not as much of an expert with the standard bow, the bow is my overall best weapon, so this will actually give me an opportunity to demonstrate maybe a little bit further on in the game.
Set.
further the distance, therefore the longer you hold down the attack button, the more damage you will do. Kind of a tip.
Upon Olympus.
The bow really is great for this type of encounter here. These enemies will just follow you around forever. And as long as they don't get too close, you can really just pull them around the room. It's quite great. Thank you. Now I just have to avoid traps. Okay. Dionysus is actually a good choice here because what you can do with this particular boon is, like as you just saw, you can use your special attack to lay poison on the whole room, basically, and keep it up fairly easily as your special tends to hit everything in sight, so hopefully we'll get that here, and if not, there's still a few other abilities we can work with. You'll notice I'm ignoring most of the adds unless they directly get in my way, because they will just keep coming back over and over again. Now if they get heavily like that, then you are at a point where it benefits you to clear them up a little bit, but for the most part, it behooves you to focus on the actual main enemy. Excellent. As you can see, quite a great option there. Everything being epic. Pretty rare for something like that to occur, so it's great to hear. Let's see. While I do like the others as well, I think we're going to stick with my original plan. And of course, another key for unlocking weapons. A great choice.
No way to patch up. Got to keep going. This can unlock a weapon back at home.
Poison does stack. You'll notice that's the reason why I'm shooting off so many, because 7 damage every half a second can stack up to 5 times, giving you a significantly higher amount of damage.
You've got quite the fight.
Just an overall boon to everything we do. A great effect.
I will keep fighting.
We have a significant amount of money, and while I could use some gems, I would prefer to get something here in this run to hopefully make it so I can last longer. So let's see what we can find.
I think I hear the river. Charon's shop. Hey, good to see you out here, mate.
Let's see here. Let's go with the heart.
Here's the fee.
And another Dionysus. Excellent. Let's go with numbing sensation. Anything we can do to slow him down, give us more time to escape. That's great. As the wise poet once said, homie, don't play that.
That'll keep me going for a bit.
Alright, so we're back here again. Let's see if we can get it done.
Oh no.
Oh no, indeed.
Your whips.
Maybe persist.
Game base. I may not have anywhere near as much survivability, but the damage sure has gone up. Boom. Alright, here. So as you can see, definitely a lot more tactical options there. Oh, that's my chair. I'm big and it makes noise. But, so yeah, luckily we got ourselves a nice little weapon upgrade. Blood here that we can use in making it past the first boss. The first major boss.
How did you...
Don't mind me, Father.
Let's see, we'll pick this to move forward. Anything we can do to give ourselves health and longevity from here on out is always beneficial.
we're getting somewhere. Bone rakers.
All we need now is some sort of shanty work song. Like back in the day.
God's grant me strength.
Just something to kind of keep you rolling along, you know?
Stronger still.
The only one I know is from Fern Gully.
Slam dancers.
You gotta be careful with these guys. Whenever you strike and kill them, they will drop a poisonous effect. Basically like a bomb. You gotta get out of the way. From our permanent rewards here, mainly because we need to be able to build up the character long term, as opposed to focusing on just getting a perfect run or what have you. So everything I'm doing here is relatively thought out, even if it seems like I'm going pretty quickly. Might be the end of me, folks. There's a lot to work through health-wise, and I just don't quite have the damage that I'm looking for. But we'll run this as much as we can. Half the time, it's all about creating a crackpot ending. Oh, but no. And fair enough. Alright, so let's go ahead and take advantage of this opportunity, do a little bit quick upgrades, prepare for the next run.
Welcome back. It's usually
glad to keep things interesting. Happen to know who?
I'm sure.
Someone's at the desk next to the throne.
Who's that snip?
That's Shin.
You're trying to...
Perhaps one...
Nice. Some sort of special offer for me, my good Shade. Work authorized. A fountain chamber in the depths of Tartarus sounds like an excellent idea.
The prodigals.
Don't worry, Meg.
Look.
Excellent, so we've got a much better this time. Let's go ahead and, as I said, focus on that Death Defiance, put that shadow in there. Now whenever we die, we automatically come back with a certain percentage of health.
How's it going?
Hey!
Let's see here. We'll recommend. Let's take a look at the spear next.
The eternal spear. Join my pursuit.
And we're still working on getting that encounter up. So far, everything we're just kind of nailing down the resources, working our way, moving forward. But let's go ahead and take a break here. If you do enjoy this and you want to see me keep doing more runs or discussing just basic commentary about what to focus on when you begin the game, let me know either by putting down a comment below or just giving this video a like and recommending it to your friends. Thanks again for joining me today, though. I hope you have a great day and have fun out there.